Welcome back to the fabulous Olympic Oval here at Baselga di Pine in the Trentino region for continued coverage from the FISU World University Speed Skating Championships. We've got highlights from the women's 500, men's 500, and then into the fun of the mass start to conclude our coverage here on Eurosport from these championships. Well, weather conditions are pretty good. We've had some evening races, but back into the sunlight for our day racing today to conclude the coverage, and it really does paint a quite beautiful picture. This facility, last used for the Universiad in Trentino 3 years ago now. What a fabulous tournament that was, and an opportunity once again for the students to return to what is basically one of the hotbeds of European speed skating, and in particular Italian speed skating. The fastest at 39.430, and she will go alongside Arisa Tsujimoto of Japan. They will be paired up as the last pair based on the seedings to see if in their second 500 meters they can joust it out for that gold medal. So this is how things will line up. It'll be Marin Sarap who goes off on her own for Estonia, then Krotova and Yang, Belarus and China, and then Boarding and Dramaleva of the Czech Republic, and then moving down to the faster seeds, it'll be Li Qishi and Arisa Tsujimoto that finish things off. Maybe Takahashi can get in amongst it as well. Japan have a good, strong side here. Nana's sister, incidentally, competing at the moment in the World All-Round Championships, Miho. But now here at these university speed skating championships. So just about ready to get things underway. A little bit of a lonely moment for Marin Sarap. But gonna try and complete this 500 meters as quickly as she possibly can. The Tallinn University IT student, in her third year, competing in the 500, 1,000, 1,500, and we will see her in the mass start as well. I think we're going to see quite a stretched out field in that mass start race, 16 laps of this track later today. A little bit ungainly coming round the corner, but trying to keep the power down. Looking for a time as close to the 40 seconds as she can get. PB of 43.410. But now the drive for the line will look a little bit more animated when we have two athletes out on the track. Before 3.18, a little bit slower second time around. Yes, didn't get away to the best start there, Marin. But stuck with the task all the way through. Now Maria Krotova, 42.41 for Krotova. She'll be paired alongside Yang Ji of China. Yang Ji with a time of 43.010 in that first race. So similar times, but you would expect Krotova of Belarus to get the drop in this one. Just a sprint away and a couple of little slips there from Krotova, but keeping this power on all the way down, not settled into her skating rhythm yet, and that's a good piece of work from the Belarus athlete. So the speed in the skates, now trying to transfer that into power throughout this race. Good low body position from Yang, but she's not quite in the same quality as Krotova. And Belarus looking to create a decent double time here for the points, somewhere in the low 80s, and gets across the line in 42.23. Yang Ji, 43.88 time, so sub 43 seconds from Krotova. We will see, I'm sure, some sub 40 skating as well. That'll be when we get to the lower seeds. Well, fast and furious when it comes to 500 metres. 13th in the 1,000 metre race at El Yasmin Boarding of the Netherlands in the distinctive orange suit up against Eliska Dramalova of the Czech Republic. Her compatriot Sablikova bidding for another all-round title at the moment in Berlin. Plenty of speed skating going on at the moment across Europe. And Dramalova in the red and blue to the left of your picture in the outside lane. Slightly more staccato steps from boarding. And both working very hard down that straight. Neck and neck then into the split as they head round this first corner. Boarding with the inside lane gets that brief advantage before skating across to the outside lane to finish off her 500. A lot of intent about that from Dramalova. And now gets that inside line, but just a little too wide from the Czech Republic skater. So the Netherlands look like they're going to set the faster time here. And that's what they do. 42.11 from Merel Yasmin Boarding. So moves her into top spot at the moment. 84. It's tally. Well, a little bit scrappy towards the end from boarding, but a solid enough time. But plenty of quality seeded to come, so we will see those times beaten. Sanne Vesterveld then. Decent time of 41.372 in her opening heat, and 41.260 is her PB, but 48.60 is Zenia Skarovrodkina's time, the Belarus athlete in the green on the outside lane. On paper, the faster of the two athletes here, but Sanne Vesterveld putting in a decent effort here and pushing very hard indeed. And this is looking good for Vesterveld, and a little bit scrappy from Skovorodkina. Well, she's settled into a rhythm now, but I think the damage has been done here, and Vesterveld with a real chance of recording the faster time. Yes, you're racing against the other person on the ice with you, but it is ultimately against the clock, and Vesterveld hanging on. That's really strong from the Dutch woman. 41.82 against Xenia's 42.11. And Vesterveld moves into the lead. Well, this is what we want to see with the way that the seedings work in reverse order through this second round of 500s. You want to see a constant improvement. And as athletes cross the line with each pairing, you want to see that lead changing hands. And at the moment, it stays with the Netherlands and Sanne Vesterveld. Steffi Wippen then of the Netherlands, going next against Linda Bortolotti of Italy. Has been the mentor for this student team coming into these championships. They've had mixed results, but they've had a couple of really good ones. Now, in terms of PBs, these two are absolutely neck and neck. Virtually nothing between them. Bolotti is just a little quicker. And Bortolotti just gets to the outside line first, but then the lanes allow Wubben to temporarily take the lead. She'll drift across to the outside lane now. Bortolotti will switch to the inside, and at the moment Netherlands look like they're going to retain the lead in the 500, but it will switch hands if Wubben can keep this going. But Bortolotti coming back strong. This is a good effort from the Italian, and this is going to be fast from her. It's going to be just over the 41 mark. 41.05 for Bortolotti, 82.620, and this home crowd here in Baselga can celebrate that one. Well, for so much of that race, Steffi looked like she had it, but Bortolotti got things together just in time. And the faster woman, marginally faster woman on paper, getting that across the line for the lead. So Italy at the moment with the lead, two pairs to go. Nana Takahashi, part of that fantastic Japanese pursuit team, along with her sister Miho. Alexandra Kapruciak of Poland, just off the podium in the 1,000 meters. Kapruciak, so looking to try and get on the podium here in the 500. The second 500 for these two then, very fast in the first. Nana just over the 40 as well as Kapruciak. Nothing between these two, can they push each other on? Good advantage then at the moment, 2/10 for Takahashi to play with here to put her into top spot. But Kapruciak is waiting for an error. And this could be the skate for the bronze medal. Depending on what happens with our final two seeds, and Takahashi determined it's going to be her. And the Japanese racer gets to the line first. It's a good time, 40.53. 81.170 for her points classification. That puts Nana Takahashi into top spot. But it means that Kapruciak is going to have to wait and see. She may have to suffer another fourth place here, and that would be unfortunate for the Polish skater, because that was a good time. The two fastest skaters then from the first 500. Arisa Tsujimoto in the darker of the two speed suits for Japan, the silver medalist in the 1,000 meters, up against the 1,000 meter champion from this World University Speed Skating Championships. And Li Qishi in the red speed suit, very purposeful drive all the way down the straight. Two quite different styles. You can see how low Tsujimoto is, and then control it. Control the speed round the bend, keep plowing the power through the skates, and that's exactly what Li is doing. But Tsujimoto is not letting her have this all her own way. This is going to unfold very nicely off the bend, and it's going to be a really tight finish. We could see two racers under the 40-second mark here. Brilliant skate from Li. It's going to be a second gold medal for the woman from China, and Tsujimoto picks up the silver. Wow, that's fast. 39.41 against 39.79. And the two fastest skaters from round one saving their best until last. A very good second round. And it's another gold medal for Li. Well, Li has a fantastic PB at 37.930. So not quite going to that level, but Tsujimoto not far off her personal best, and confirmation. That gold medal going to Li, silver to Tsujimoto. And Takahashi once again just keeping Kapruciak of Poland off of the podium. So just a little unfortunate for the Polish skater, but the Chinese skater Li dominant from start to finish in that one. So that's it for the ladies 500. We'll be hearing from the Hungarian skater Konrad Nagy after the break, and then we'll be moving over to the men's 500. And there's that final classification score. Quite a decent advantage in the end for Li to take that gold medal. Welcome back to Italy. The first 500 meter race has happened. That'll seed our racers through in their pairs in reverse order, basically. So the strongest with the best chance of the gold medal will go last. And at the moment, Mirko Giacomo Nenzi, the Italian star, is leading this one just ahead of Yuto Fujino. Great skate from Yuto. So those two will go in the last group. But, well, we already heard Konrad Nagy mention the Taipei skater, and Ching-Yang Sung has every chance of setting a time that will prove to be the mark. He'll skate alongside Artem Zolotarev, the Russian, in pair nine. So Robert Goodwin goes on his own. Then we've got nine pairs to follow. And confirmation that pairs 9 and 10, that'll be interesting. Conrad just a little bit off the pace at the moment. And he's going to have to find a very special time skating in pair eight. So once again, that slightly lonely feel for Robert Goodwin, the American, with a PB of 39.550. He'll have to skate this one on his own. First 500 meters a little off where we know he can be, 41.136, the slowest time. He won't be happy with that at all. So we'll want to try and improve on that, but not easy when it's just you against the clock. The specialist skates that the speed skaters in long track use. A close up of those and just how big those blades are. Well, the crouch start from Goodwin. Away he goes. Trying to just tighten it up as he comes around and gets into his rhythm. The man from the University of Illinois, first year social sciences students, competing across pretty much all the disciplines. It's a great experience for him. Even though he's not going to be amongst the medals, he can say that he's been there and done it. And he is going to be over the 40-second mark, I'm afraid. 41.28 for the American. Going to go a lot faster than that. Mirko Giacomo Nenzi's time in that first 500, 35.946. That was impressive. And I think that going up against Fujino is going to push him on. The pair will be looking for something fast just to shut out the rest. Elmar Visse then for the Netherlands in the red speed suit up against Michael Koenig. Robert Goodwin's compatriot from the USA. Both men with sub 40 PBs. Visser marginally quicker in that first leg at 39.012, but Koenig not far behind at all. So this one should be a close one on paper. Quite an upright stance initially from Koenig, then settles into his work, but that classic Dutch style. Two-arm shift all the way down the straight from Visser, and that was powerful. So no surprise to see half a second the advantage, and the number one in brackets next to his name means that at the moment on the overall classification, Visser would move into top spot, but would like to set a mark that would maybe just claim a few scalps along the way. And that was a little bit wide from Visser, nearly came to grief there. And this has turned into a real race. Wow, little dive for the line from Koenig. Didn't quite pay off. This has still managed to win that one, but by a narrow margin, just 0.06 of a second. And it was that last bend that caused Visser the problem. As he came out from this, he drifts very, very wide and took a long, long time to get back from that dirty ice to the clean part of the track. Well, our first photo of the day goes the way of the orange speed suit. For Czech Krasniki of Poland in the red, and the familiar green suit of Belarus, Kondratsev. Once again, both men's times relatively similar, which is why they've been paired together, second 500. 38.724 for Maxim, and 38.505 for Wojciech. Much quicker step phase from the Belarus skater. But it's the power of Krasniki now that will start to tell. Really did bury the skates in the last few drives into that first corner. And now Krasniki will make his way across to the outside of the track. Very muscular skater, built a little more like Konrad Noj that we saw in our feature. Whereas Kondratsev, a little more rangy, and he's just going to lose out here. Yeah, good skate in the end from Krasniki. So 38.35 for the Polish skater puts him into top spot with that classification points, the combination of points across both of the races. 76. He got the power down. It was very convincing. Andrew Turner in the US blue and white suit, and Bart Vrugdenhiel, we've seen him in action a couple of times already at this championship. Bart with a superior personal best, so on paper the man in the orange suit should be quicker. 38.153 was a good time, but Turner nearly matched him, 38.378 with the first 500. So second 500 to come for these two. And a little twitch there means starter's not happy. Out comes the red flag. You can be given a false start for all sorts of reasons, but one of them is that you go but don't actually cross the line, and your body movement is enough to make your opponent jump the gun. It was pretty close to that. Second visit then to the start. Backskate dug in. Vrugdenhiel, remember, the faster of the two men on the outside. Both into their work very quickly. That's quick arms from Andrew Turner. The American dives into the inside bend a little quicker. So third for Vrugdenhiel at the moment, fourth for Turner on the overall classifications, even with the advantage. Just shows you how fast they're gonna have to go in order to claim the top spots. And just getting caught out a little on that tight bend, but doing very well in the end. Bart coming off that nicely, and Vrugdenhiel dives for the line, and it's fast enough for the lead. 76.200 after that time of 38.05. And the time's getting faster and faster as we move through the field. Well, he was all over the place, diving for the line there, and busy undoing the zip before he got to the line. So nearly mistimed it, but Vrugdenhiel leads for the Netherlands. Holland v Holland in this next one. Barry Spahn up against Olaf Gerritsen. Gerritsen's sister with those Olympic medals. I think it's difficult when you follow a sibling into a sport, especially if that sibling has been successful. Those comparisons are always going to be made. And away we go. And between the two of them, there isn't much at all. There's about 3/10 on paper in terms of PB for the man on the left-hand side of your picture. And Gerritsen just missing out there. Spahn looked very fast indeed to the break. And if he keeps moving at this pace, Barry Spahn can take the lead here in Italy. Good rhythm from both men into that next curve. The inside lane for Gerritsen. Can Gerritsen make it count? Trying really hard, moving through the gears, and this one's going to be tight, but Gerritsen's going to set the fastest time of the two. 37.84 for Gerritsen, and it's good enough for the lead again. And we keep moving this lead every single round. Spahn at the moment dropping into the silver medal position. Remember, two sets of 500 metres combining for that classified point score. Factored point score across the two times. Did really well, didn't he, Gerritsen, coming off that inside line. And just built the speed all the way down the straight. So the Netherlands, rather like the women's race, hanging on to the lead for the moment. Armin Hager of Austria, very fast man, over 500 when he gets it right. 35.880 his PB. Goes up against another quick man, Steve Hartman, who's 36.530, which is very respectable, I can tell you. Rather pales when it's next to Hager's quick time. Hager, short, compact, muscular, fast. The Austrian with the dark blue and silver speed suit. as the inside lane for this first straight, and it's quick. That is an incredibly low body position from the Austrian as he drives into the first curve. Both men absolutely dead heating, 0.03 of a second off the split, which if it stays like that means that neither of them will be able to claim the lead. Hager moves to the outside line. Hartmann is not done yet. Very smooth style from the far taller American, but he drifts a little wide off that last bend. That'll cost him some valuable tenths, but he gets it across the line in a solid time. And that's a great skate from Hartmann. 37.52 means 75.070. So Hartmann does move to the top of the classification standings with four pairings to go. He's at least given himself a chance, but 75.072, that is beatable still. Mikhail Domansky. Good skate from him in the first 500 at 37.525, goes up against Christian Satorato. Satorato a little bit quicker at 37.425, but as we get to the faster athletes, it's fractions separating some of them. Satorato then, the Italian, in the outside lane. And Domansky, the Polish skater on the inside. Look for the faster start from Domansky. He's a quick man over the opening part of this race, but Satorato nearly matching him, going to the outside bend. Well, he has matched him. That is neck and neck. Both men then would be in silver medal position if they kept it as a photo across the line. That's not going to happen though, and they'll sort it out over this next couple of hundred meters. Satorato dives for the inside lane. That's a good skate from the Italian, but comes off a little hot from the corner, but he's kept that speed going very nicely, and that's good work from Christian. Christian Satorato takes over in the gold medal position with a classification of 74.490. Well, that's pretty good work from one of the younger athletes at this championships. Three pairings to go, and the three pairings contain athletes that were all tipped for medals here. Alessio Trentini then goes for Italy from the University of Trento, second year student in cognitive sciences, up against the man that we featured earlier in our program from Hungary, Konrad Nagy. Nagy. Nagy, after the gold and bronze medals on day one and two, looking to get onto the podium here on day three, but I think he's got his work cut out. Left himself a lot to do after that first 500. Well, it's tidy enough from Nagy. Trentini, though, with the marginal advantage, good enough for silver medal position at the moment as they come down the back straight. Nagy transfers to that outside line. And at the moment, Trentini looking pretty good, but he's lost some of that initial impetus. And Nagy driving for the line. Is it good enough? Well, from Nagy will tell you all you need to know. As far as he's concerned, that isn't going to be enough. Not with the quality that we have in the final two pairings. Nagy will have to wait and see if it's going to be a third medal from this championships. Artem Zolotarev then of Russia against the man that Nagy feared most coming into this championships, Ching-Yang Sung of Taipei, a PB of 34.640. And the man from Taipei in that very distinctive speed suit. Arms and legs so quick, so powerful through their movements. And watch him build this speed. He nearly clattered into the back there of Zoltarev coming off the bend. That's how much speed he was carrying, and this is going to be a good time from Sung. Just tying up a little to the line and just mistiming his finish there. But Sung gets it across for the lead. It's fast. It is fast. Sub 36 seconds, 35.93. And Sung moves himself into top spot. The man from Chinese Taipei with a very fast skate, and but for a little bit of a stutter there towards the end, might have even shaved another 100 or so off it. So Sung leads, and that's a good lead. Zoltarev in silver medal position, and Noj bumped down to bronze with one pairing to go. And it's their medals to lose. Yuto Fujino of Japan up against the man with the fastest PB in this field. Well, apart from Sung, that is. And Enrico, the Olympic medalist, looks on. Enrico Fabri has been looking after this Italian team. Knows Mirko Giacomo Nenzi very well, the senior citizen in this Italian setup, approaching his later 20s. 28 years of age is the maximum age at the university championships. And the Italian, Nenzi, on the right hand, on the left hand side of your screen, working well in that outside lane. But Fujino trying not to let him have it all his own way. Nenzi, though, settles into his rhythm. That's a very good outside bend, and I think Nenzi's carrying a lot of speed here. Got some work to do if he wants that gold medal. Such was Sung's skate, but remember, those last few meters for Sung may have cost him. That's very wide from Nenzi. Is that going to be a problem? The Italian driving for the line and gold. And is he there? Yes, he is. Mirko Giacomo Nenzi has done it. 71.760, that overall classification. And a good time at 35.82. And that will keep this Italian crowd happy here in Baselga di Pine. Certainly going to keep the coach and mentor Enrico Fabri happy. Well, that was a fiercely determined skate. And after Sung put the cat amongst the pigeons in that penultimate pair, that's a brilliant response from Nenzi. Confirmation then on that second 500 that Nenzi sets the fastest time. For the Italian, but I'm not sure. Well, we'll have to see if it's good enough for Fujino. Very close to Zoltarev, but I think he's probably done enough for the medal, and it is confirmed. Yuto Fujino then of Japan picks up the bronze medal. Ching-Yang Sung, what a fabulous skate from him. He will take the silver, and Mirko Giacomo Nenzi takes the gold medal for Italy. And Italy's fortunes improving on the final day. That's it then for the men's 500. And we're going to turn our attentions to the interesting and exciting mass start racing for the remainder of this competition. We'll be back after the break with the women's mass start race. So stay with us. Welcome back. Conditions just getting a little bit foggy as we move into the early evening here at the Baselga di Pine Ice Stadium. This Olympic oval track here in Trentino, hosting the University Speed Skating Championships, and that's our start list for the ladies' mass start. We've got 11 competitors going to head off, so Marin Sarap is in there, and final part of the page belongs to Willemijn. Instructions, each having to wear a safety helmet. The number on the side will allow us, well, I hope, some chance of identification, although not always easy when you're away from the skaters on the mass starts. So 16 laps of skating, and in amongst those 16 laps, three sprint sections, 5 points if you take the sprint section, three if you finish second, one if you finish in third position. But if you cross the line at the end of those 16 laps in the lead, you get a straight 60 points. If you cross the line in second, it's 40, and crossing the line in third, it's 20. So sometimes those sprints will be factored in, but we've got a very slow tactical start to this race, so there's an opportunity for somebody, maybe one of the lower seeds, to grab a name for themselves here. There's a couple of fairly quick athletes in this group that might fancy a dart at the first sprint. And very slowly through the opening lap. Well, cat and mouse at the moment. Bortolotti for Italy in first place, 51.66 seconds for the first 400. That's how I skate. But it is tactical. It's all about waiting for position, waiting to see who's going to make the break. And at the moment, Annemarie Boer, one of the favourites for the medals, is just keeping a careful eye on this. Boer in the number four safety helmet. Moves it a little wider, just offering the track. But being given some very close attention there by number five, Marin Sarap. The Estonian, well, she knows which side her bread is buttered. She is very definitely trying to track Boer here. And nobody giving anything away at the moment. You are allowed to place your hands on the athlete in front just to keep your distance and keep it safe, but you can't boost them and you certainly can't interfere with their progress. And at the moment, Boer not really being given a challenge. Now, opportunities here developing. Boer has decided to drop to the back of the pack. That's left Willem Cnossen in top position. And just behind her, Giulia Lollobrigida, the Italian ace here at these championships. Lollobrigida might fancy a dart at the sprint. And just in behind Lollobrigida is Bortolotti again, who led it out round that first lap. Gradual ramping up of the pace. They're starting to move now, and here we go. The first sprint. Cnossen fancies it. It's going to be very tight, but I think it's going to be Lollobrigida, you know. It is. And Giulia Lollobrigida takes the 5 points. Bortolotti, the fellow Italian, taking three, but Willemijn Cnossen keeps the pace going after the sprint. So single point in the bank for Cnossen. And now away and clear at the top of the field, and we're starting to lose Marin Sarap. I'm not sure she's going to finish this race with 11 laps to go. Well, Cnossen, if she keeps this distance between her and the rest of the field, she's going to pick up some more sprint points on the way. But remember, a group of athletes working together, just like a peloton in cycling, can work far more effectively in closing down an athlete that is out there on their own in front. And Cnossen's going to have to have a little think about how she wants to play this. Here comes the push from the chasing pack. They will share the workload to get back to Cnossen. And remember, Annemarie Boer will have to contribute to that. So Cnossen in the lead as we go through the 4 minute mark. Now, 16 laps is a long way when you're skating it at this pace. Sometimes it can be a lot quicker. 9 laps to go. Belt signalling to let the racers know there's another sprint on, so points to be picked up, and I think Cnossen has just picked herself up 5 there. So first sprint, she picked up the single, kept the pace going. She's out in the lead on her own. She's taken the 5 off this one. She's going to surely take the next sprint as well. That's when things are going to get tricky for Cnossen. That's when the chasing pack will really work hard to close her down. But they're going to have to be careful not to let her get too far away here. At the moment, the work being done by Jessica Merkens of the Netherlands, along with Bortolotti. And that's confirmation of that last sprint, 5 points going the way of Cnossen. Well, if she wins the next sprint, that's 11 points in the bank, but that's going to count for nothing if she can't then find a way into the top part of the race. And once this group of chasing athletes decides to go and decides to get moving, they are going to travel very quickly indeed. Still Jessica Merkens exerting a certain amount of control over that pack. Annemarie Boer alongside her. Well, ideally, if they can time everything right here, then they could end up with a 1-2-3, the Dutch, but the rest of the field have got other ideas. They're not going to let that happen. And it's Kasia Wozniak of Poland that decides to ramp it up and take it out. She's had enough of Cnossen away and clear. And Wozniak being chased down by Jessica Merkens, who's closed it up pretty quickly. And they're going to use Wozniak now as Cnossen makes her way towards another pretty easy 5 points. But there will surely be a point towards the end of this race where that closing group will just simply swallow Cnossen up. Five laps to go then, that's still a long way. Five ovals of 400 meters. And still the work being done by Wozniak. Break, mini break forming with that particular group of athletes. Wozniak in there, Merkens in there, Annemarie Boer, one of the favorites for gold in there. So still things good for her. And I think Olesya Chernega as well, the Russian, is there. They are gonna get to Cnossen very, very shortly. Not in time for the sprint points, but that's irrelevant now. Cnossen is going to be swallowed up by this chasing pack. There's another 5 points in the bank. Wozniak picks up the three, Merkens picks up the one, and looking very keen, Merkens moves to the front. Wozniak just slipstreaming her, and behind them, Anna Pristalova of Russia, and Cnossen is gone. So that initial work from her not paying off. Although she has cancelled out other challenges as well from other nations and left the door very firmly open. Two Dutch skaters then in this breakout pack of five. At the back there, Olesya Chernega just keeping an eye on things alongside Annemarie Boer. So Chernega and Boer not wanting too much to do with the speed at the moment. And they're going to get caught by the pack they just broke from, although Boer has other ideas. Little false break from Boer, just to see who fancies it. And the two Russians tuck in with her. Pristalova just behind her, Chernega in third. And Wozniak still part of that group, as well as Jessica Merkens. It's their turn to keep a very close eye on the front markers. Not the most conducive conditions to skating this evening. That's the chasing pack looking slightly labored. There is Eliska Drimalova. She's already skated a lot, the Czech Republic skater at these championships. Into the last 400 meters, and Annemarie Boer has a clear run here, moves herself nicely. Struggle to find a way through here. She's going to have to be very careful coming round this last bend. But Annemarie Boer has it all her own way at the moment. The gold is waiting for the Dutch woman. It's going to be gold for Annemarie Boer, the favourite at the start of this race to take it. He's going to take this one home. She's done it brilliantly. And just behind her, Chernega dives for the line ahead of Merkens. So Russia get the silver. And Merkens makes it two Dutch on the podium. That final sprint lap for the big points gives 60 to Boer. The 20 points going to Merkens, along with her two from the other sprints for third positions, making it 22. And that's not going to be enough to overhaul Olesya Chernega's straight 40 for the last sprint. That was a great piece of work from Boer. And tactically very astute all the way through what was a highly tactical race. That was very tricky indeed. Wozniak then just missing out in fourth position. Good effort from her. But there's your 1-2-3. Boer, Chernega and Merkens, the Russian, just getting in between the two Dutch women. Well, decent mass start race, that one. Interesting to watch. Interesting development. But in the end, it was the power and tactical nous of Annemarie Boer that allowed her to win that one. And once she had a clear run into that last lap, she controlled things very, very nicely indeed. Got some earlier highlights from the race. That was Marin Serrat just losing her way. That was the initial break from Cnossen. And without concern, without worry, the chasing pack just gradually ramped it up. They left Cnossen to her own devices. She was eventually overhauled. That was that first little break from Boer to go past her compatriot. And then Boer just kept injecting little bits of pace until the final go. That was a good straight 400 meters worth of power from Boer to claim the medal, and a decent charge for the line from Chernega, meaning Russia pick up that second place, just denying Merkens for the bronze, and Merkens in turn just denying Wozniak and Pristalova. Good race then from the Dutch, and straight over to Cnossen to say well done. Good try, good try. So, really enjoyable race. Let's hope the men's mass start is as entertaining as the women's. That's coming up after the break. Stay with us. Just the men's mass start race to conclude business here at the FISU World University Speed Skating Championships in Northern Italy. We were due to have 17 men at the start line, but it looks like that's been reduced. Alexei Gorshkov of Russia, and not surprised to hear that Konrad Nozh of Hungary have decided they're going to dip out of this 16 laps. So let's take a look at what we have left. 15 races to go, so it's going to be pretty congested out there. And moving down through the start list, plenty of names that we've already seen in action during the course of this week. Athletes to keep an eye on, well, Bugatti and Giotto from Italy should be strong. Hager also good when it comes to mass starts. We've seen how good he is as a sprinter over the shorter distances, but pretty comfortable as well when it comes to the 16 lappers. Now, with the fog closing in, we're gonna really have to keep our eyes peeled to try and see these athletes as they move around through the track. But I wouldn't be surprised if we get a group moving away fairly early. We've got some quality athletes in here, and I think they will back themselves. They certainly won't want to be caught up in any traffic and have any early problems. So slightly quicker, slightly more urgency than that very slow tactical start that we saw from the women. But they won't be flying just yet. Ooh, little stumble out in front there from the man with the number one on the side of his safety helmet, Wojciech Suit. And Suit having a little look around to see who else would like to come through and pick up some work at the front. Anton Kapustin is happy to oblige for Belarus. And just a little injection of pace there from number nine, Vasily Melnikov of Russia. Play with each other's minds as they move around this track. And then you'll get the real break, the real pace. Klev Astapov of Belarus moving temporarily into that top spot, but quickly usurped by Daniel Niero. of Italy. Nero, another name that you've got to keep an eye on. Keep an eye on as well, Marcin Bacinek. He's had a good championship so far. And Heidegger, the other Austrian. All guys very, very capable of pace. First 5 points then on offer as we move towards the opening sprint of three before we get to the big last lap sprint where the big points are earned. So this is 5-3-1 for first, second, third, and the first sprint. We'll have to wait for confirmation to see if it is Soot that claims it. And we'll see if he decides to keep his pace going. No, he doesn't. Just glides through the line. So 5 points in the bank, I think, for Soot. Confirmed, Niero with three, Bugatti with one. Those points can be rather elementary when it comes to the end of the race. Well, we do have some movement at the front of the field. Bugatti and Niero have gone for Italy by the looks of it. Giotto not far behind them. Bugatti, genuine quality as a mass start racer. He's in the number 10 helmet in third position. And making sure that this break doesn't actually happen with any real impetus. Like the Dutchman Leitenberg, but I'll confirm that for you when we get sufficiently out of the fog to be able to do so. Well, mass starts are never easy to call, but less so when visibility is like this. It is the number three helmet then, Ronald Leitenberg of the Netherlands. So 9 laps to go. To the halfway mark. And from here, I fancy Bugatti to keep this ramped up sufficiently to cause a real problem for the chasing pack. At the moment, content to work in there though. With his takes the five, Bugatti the three, Leitenberg the one. Are they going to keep this going or are they going to relax back in? That's a big long look over his shoulder from Bugatti. Bugatti happy to let this pack back to them and once again injects just a little bit of pace. Interesting tactically here. David Giotto now taking over the workload for the Italians. So Giotto it is from Linus Heidegger. Still no showing as yet from Armin Hager. He's kept himself in the pack. Bacinek is in the pack. After that early bit of promise from Melnikov, he seems to have faded a little. From Soot's point of view, he is completely out of the picture now, dropping further and further behind. So Giotto through the split at 5:34.91 with the lead. Heidegger just behind him. This race building very nicely indeed. And if it stays this congested, we are going to see a massive build to that sprint. Giotto, a little look across to the coaches with 5 laps to go. You need as much information as you can glean. Still no separation, but Giotto is very cleverly not allowing the pace to settle down to anything too pedestrian. He's moving a little bit of pace in there. And Riccardo Bugatti now ghosts back into second position with Armin Hager. First showing we've seen from the moving in and out of third and fourth along with Heidegger. Heidegger just in front of him. Well, if Hager's there when we hear the bell for the final lap, then that is a man that has serious speed, so keep an eye on him. Bacinek also can be quick. Bacinek in sixth position at the moment in the red and white speed suit of Poland. Just tucking in behind Kapustin of Belarus. Now, another little break here coming round the outside is number 11, Vugdenhill. And Vugdenhill of the Netherlands just injecting that pace, but he's been matched quite comfortably by Giotto. Then another slingshot move. Ivan Sulukin of Russia takes the gamble. And the guys who know that they don't quite have it in the legs come the end are just trying to get some of this speed away from the really quick men. And this race is heating up very nicely indeed. Now they've caught him. Now this is going to get very interesting indeed. Hager bursts to the front with Bugari tracking him very closely. Hager leading for Austria. Bugari just off the pace, going a little bit wide there, but needs to sort this out. And they're gradually closing the gap now. They've lapped Soot. He's out of the race. Don't worry about him. This is all about these leading two. Brilliant work from Hager, and they dive for the line. Well, I don't know that Hager has timed that particularly well, and I think he's given it away to Bugari. He has, according to that graphic, he has, and Hager was on for a good result there in terms of the gold medal and just missed timing things. Well, let's hope that's not a real problem for Olaf Geriksen in this fog. Just did not see the incident that meant he went to the ice. And confirmation, Riccardo Bugatti beats Hager to the line. Hager Niero in fourth and Heidegger the only other man to pick up a point from the sprint. But a good showing from Austria and a good showing from Italy in that men's mass start. Well, that was a really enjoyable couple of mass start races, something to really mull over and watch. And some young student athletes in there showing maturity beyond their years. Very cool and calm from Bugatti. And as we take a little look back at some of the line, doesn't quite drive all the way through. That's early work from Soot on the initial sprint, but he was eventually overpowered and lapped. Chasing pack did their job, closed it down. Bugatti for the briefest of moments along with Niero. And Leitenberg just conducting a mini break, but then they allowed the group back to them. All the time you see Bugatti looking over his shoulder, but once that group got back, then Hager got himself in a really good position, and when he made the break for the front on the final lap after the bell, it did look like it was going to be Hager's race, but he looked so casual on the line, just didn't time it, and that allowed Bugatti through to take the goal. Fantastic stuff.